The code will be saved. Actually, Brain Mentors and Ravi is like equal. So you can write about Brain Mentors or Ravi. You can write about the session. Just write about the session you are just being given with Brain Mentors.
All the trainers of Brain Mentor are duplicate copies. I must say this.
Pardon, sir?
All the mentors of Brain Mentors are copying of each other. Because I have attended the session in our Bharatiya College of Engineering also. So if you give the remarks to Brain Mentors or Ravi sir, then both are equal.
Actually, I am the founding member of Brain Mentors.
Yes, sir. I'm connecting 8mm since very long. This time only I have requested her.
So 8mm told me about it.
Yes, sir.
So did you attend the FDP when I came to your college?
Sir, I just took one session. After that, I had a meeting with the director, sir. Then I left the session, sir. Just 1 hour or 1.5 hour session I took, sir. At the time of when you came at the Bharatiya College.
And which session was that?
Sir, it's a 3 years, 2 years ago.
Okay, okay. I guess that was the first session. Okay.
Yeah, that is very long time, sir.
Yes, sir.
Along with the teaching work, I am also involving in the more administration and non-teaching work, no, sir. So many times I miss this type of activities.
Okay, sir. Sir, can you tell us about training data set? What training data set you want to know? Which data set are you talking about?
Can do one thing also, sir. We
yes,
can
sir.
Ask. We can ask randomly from the participants what they have learnt during these 2 days. At the end, that will also be a conclusion of the workshop.
Yeah, exactly. We'll be taking a review kind of.
Yes,
and
yes.
Just ask them to open their camera and then whatever they just like to share.
Hmm.
For recommendation system, if you remember, I told you earlier that if there is a specification here, like if I want to find out the movie recommendation system data, then I told you there is a data set named as movie lens. Okay, so there could be different data sets related to what recommendation system you want to build. Like for books, I also told you one. Yes, we are
sir,
starting
your voice. Ravi sir, your voice is breaking little bit.
Okay.
Might be you have take the volume high of your mic, I think.
Yeah, it's high actually. Let me see it once.
See, earlier it was very fine, sir.
Okay, is it clear now, sir?
Yes, sir, yes.
Okay, so I think we should start now. So first of all, let's say we have a data set. I'll share the link of data set, but what are the packages and what are the things that we are going to do? So if you want to code with me right now, then you can do that as well. If you want to learn first, then you can do it. It totally depends on you. I will just give you freedom for that. First of all, in this case study, we'll be doing basic analysis, doing data pre-processing, then we'll be applying machine learning. So what packages I need? You need pandas to import the data. You need NumPy. You need a matplotlib to plotting. Now after that, there are few more packages that we need. Like if I want to perform data pre-processing, then the package is sklearn.preprocessing, and from there I can import standard scalar. So standard scalar package will be used for standardization. There is another package that we will be requiring here, that is label encoder, and one package, one hot encoder. I will explain each and every one. Each and every package, I will explain it to you. So right now, just import. And remember, if you're writing, then the spellings should be exactly like this. And it is case sensitive. Remember this. From sklearn.svm, or let's say first, if I want to work with logistic regression, that is, it is present inside linear model. Now we are not writing algorithm of logistic regression or SVM. We are using a predefined package. I will tell you a basic maths of linear logistic regression and SVM. From sklearn.model selection, we will import train test split to divide the data into training and testing. From sklearn.metrics, we will import accuracy score, classification report. Okay, so we'll be importing these packages. And why we need these packages? Because at the end, I have to print out the accuracy with precision, recall, and all. So each and everything will be present to you. So these are the basic requirements. These are the basic packages that you need first. And right now, do not worry about each and every package. We'll just go through one by one. So first, let's do one thing. Let's read the data. So you will just write pd.read_csv. In a dataset variable, now you need a dataset. So I am going to share the URL of dataset. So I am sharing in the chat window the URL of dataset. And I will just print dataset.head to check whether the data has been imported successfully. Yes, it is. Are we clear till here? And it's not necessary that you have to code side by side. You can just understand all the things, and later on you can take the video from Vishal sir, and then you can implement it later as well. Okay, right now if you want, then you can just pay attention and learn it carefully. Okay, so I think that you should do it as well. Like, just take the video from Vishal sir, and then you can just view it 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, and then code it again and again. Depends on you. But right now the main thing is you have to understand the concepts, because this case study is a full-fledged example, like how to do data analysis, then data pre-processing, and then apply machine learning, and then check the accuracies. Read CSV is for reading.csv file. Yeah, you can read Excel files as well, or some other files which are comma separated actually, or which are some in tabular form. You can read few other files, not just with extension of .csv. Okay, so first we just read the data. Now let's see what exactly the data is. Data contains few column: country, age, gender, fever, body pain, runny nose, difficulty in breathing, nasal congestion, sore throat, severity level, contact with COVID patient, and infected. Now there are a lot of parameters which will tell you whether you are infected or not. For Excel, there is a method known as read underscore Excel. Okay. If there is error in logistic regression, then might be there is some spelling mistake or something. So I will just copy paste and share you all the things in chat window. Okay. All the packages that I have imported, I have shared you in chat window. Now let's get back. So first I just read the data. Print the head. Now let's see what are the columns. Columns are given like country name is there. There is age parameter, gender parameter, fever, or it means the body temperature, body pain 1-0. Like whether you have the body pain or not, whether you have running nose or not, difficulty in breathing or not. Based on all these parameters, at the end, I will tell you whether you are infected or not. Okay. So now this data is perfect example of data pre-processing. Like it contains the values in text form. So what you have to do there, how you are going to convert it, lot of things we have to do. First, let's perform a basic analysis that how many countries of data is there. So you will write pd.unique and let's print data set square bracket country. So it will print all the unique countries available in data. So these are the countries. So there are a lot of countries, I think. So to get the length of all the countries, just print the length of this array. So we have data of 97 countries. Okay. So we have data set of 91 countries and these are the cases. So you can just think that these are the testing cases, like testing was performed and at the end it was found that whether the person has been infected or not after testing with these parameters. So when you want to implement machine learning, first I told you about getting a basic analysis of your data. Get the basic details of it, like check what are the unique values given in gender column. So again, you will write pd.unique dataset gender. So let's see what are the unique values in gender. So in this gender column, we have three values, male, female, and transgender. Okay. After that, we have one more column which contains text value, that is severity level. And there is another one that is contact with COVID patient. So we have two more columns with text data. So we will see what are the unique values in those data, in those columns. So pd.unique again. And inside the unique, we will pass data set. Name of the column was so inside this, we have again three unique values, mild, moderate, and severe. Again, let's check for data set and then check whether the person with was in contact with COVID patient or not. Let's check what are the unique values. Here we have four unique values: no, not known, yes, and yes. There is a problem in this particular column. Yes is two times, one with capital Y and one with a small y. Okay, now you will get why I was checking the unique values, because it is also a problem for us. If you are getting the values like this, then you know what will be the problem for you. Then you have four unique values, but actually there should be three unique values. So what you should do now? Tell me, what is the solution for this? According to you, what do you think? Yes, simple, convert it into a same case, either into a lower or into a title case. So let's see how to convert it. Let's go to dataset column. And there is contact with COVID patient column. I want to do one thing here, that data set square bracket contact with COVID patient. Now, how to convert it into lowercase? Type here dot str. First, I will convert it into a string and then convert it into a lowercase. Then again, check the unique values. I converted all the values in unique lowercase. So now we have only three things. No, not non, yes. Is it clear to everyone? Okay, so whenever you want to apply any function that is related to string, so you have to write the name of column, then dot str, and then dot lower. The method is lower here. Now we can move forward after that. Data set variable is one list. Yeah, it's a one, you can say series, okay, one array. Not just by list, you can understand it by list, but actually if in terms of data analysis, I will say it's a series, single column, one dimensional data, that is one dimensional array, or you can say. Now after that, if I want to perform a basic analysis, can we convert to title case? Yeah, you can convert it into title case, upper case, lower case. In database, so in this existing data, you can insert any kind of new column. Exactly, you can insert it. Okay, so first let me show you a basic analysis. And if you want to see like how to insert a new column, then let's say you have data set variable, square bracket, and what is the name of column? Like we have the column name, state. And now you have the value of states in some variable. Let's say state is a list, it's a anything, but you have data available in this, then it will add a new column in your data with the name of state. Okay, so you can do this to add a new column. After that, let me show you basic analysis. Let's say just group by all the data with their countries. So I will write data set dot group by country column, and let's do a basic analysis on any column you can pick, like infected, not infected, like that. So if I fetch infected column, then obviously you cannot do sum and all, but let's say if I find out the temperature, the fever column, then I can find out mean of each and every country. Okay, so I group by all the data with the countries, and I find out the mean of their fever column. But this is for both the cases, whether the person is infected or not. But if you want to work on only infected part, then first you will find out the infected data. So infected will be equals to data set square bracket, again data set square bracket, column name is infected. And infected, you will check, will be double equals to one. So whose value is one? Those persons are actually infected. Now, if you write down this line again, now you will see what is the temperature, what is the body temperature of infected people. Okay, in this case, here we are having the mean of those people who are infected with coronavirus, and this is the average temperature of their body. Why two data set is given? Yesterday I told you, when we work with the condition, when you write a single condition like this, in return you only get true and false, because you are writing a condition, obviously you will get either true or false. But if you wrap this particular inside one more square bracket, then the true values will be returned. That data frame will be returned, which is true. That's why two square bracket. This is syntax of pandas condition. Okay. Let's move after that. Now we will do one thing. Copy this. We'll paste it and I can also plot it. But you cannot just do plotting like this because there are a lot of countries, and if you are just grouping by countries like this, then it will give you some outputs like these. So what I will do is plot dot. Let's say if I try to plot bar, but there are a lot of countries. Problem is that. So the bar plot will be, I guess might be it happens that cases are equal. So we won't do like this. Better thing will be like just find out the data set of single country and then plot the cases or temperature, whatever you want to plot there. That will be better. That like, yeah, we did yesterday. Okay. But is it clear till here for you? Like just how to do group by and all, then find out, you can find out the mean, sum and all these things. Is it clear till here, everyone? Any doubt? Okay. Now this was a basic analysis. Okay. Now yesterday I told you how to perform few more things, like how to visualize this data. And I also shared the video of Matplotlib on the group. You can go through it and then you can again visualize your data. So this was the first stage that we did a basic analysis. Now we will go for data pre-processing part. After performing the basic analysis, let's see a data pre-processing part now. In data pre-processing, I have imported three packages, standard scaler, label encoder, one hot encoder. So let me tell you about these packages first. First thing is standard scaler, which means standardization, which comes under feature scaling. So feature scaling has two things, standardization and normalization. And then there is a formula of normalization and standardization. So I'll tell you what exactly these are and why we are doing this. Please write syntax of bar plot. I need for some. Okay, I will write the plot of bar as well. So the normalization is x minus minimum of x divide by maximum of x minus minimum of x. So basically we have two things here. One is x parameter, then x minus minimum of x divide by maximum of x minus minimum of x. So it will normalize your values between 0 and 1. So all the data will be between 0 and 1. This is the first thing. Okay. And why we are normalizing? We are normalizing because each and every value has different unit. I told you yesterday the data has different units. You remember when I told you about the data science lifecycle and I told you the data pre-processing? Then I was telling you about this thing, that data in each and every column has different units. Like there is a column in our data which is telling the age, and now age could be till 100, any value. Then we have column something like gender, which will be into 0-1 form. Fever, again it is a value above 100. So the values are different, the ranges are different here. So that's why we do scaling. And for scaling, this is the first thing, normalization. Either you can go for normalization. And the second thing is standardization, which formula is x minus mean of x divided by standard deviation. This is the formula for standardization. And standardization will give you a normal distribution kind of a scaling, which do not, like, the range is not fixed like 0 to 1. The values could be from minus 3 to plus 3, minus 2 to plus 3. Are you getting my point? So basically, whenever you want to work with a normal distribution kind of thing, then you can go with standardization formula. Or if you do not want negative values, you want only positive values, then you can go with this, because this will give you only positive values from 0 to 1. Okay. So that's why we imported standard scalar here. Now I hope you understood why we imported standard scalar. Now let's talk about label encoder and one hot encoder. Label encoder and one hot encoder is for the columns who has the values in text, like gender is male, female, transgender. And again, we have columns like contact with foreigner, something like that. We have column, and inside that column, we have no, yes, or not, non, like these values. Okay. So what will be the problem? Problem will be that you cannot apply mathematics on these columns because this is text. So that's why we first encoded label encoder. Label encoder, let's say you have gender, male, and female. The output will be 0 and 1. Now we have three values, contact, and in contact, we have also three values in gender, but right now I'm just assuming 0 and 1 for that label encoding. Label encoding will convert it to 0 and 1. If you have contact, yes, no, or don't know, you have three values. Now it will be converted into 0, 1, and 2. This will be the output. But actually, I do not want to convert into 0 and 2. I want label encoders to be into binary form. But if you are applying label encoding in contact, it will give you 0, 1, and 2. But this is not the case because this is not binary now. 2 has a value which is greater than 1 and it will impact more. Because if you add or multiply something with 2, it will give you different results as in compare with 1 and 0. So this is not binary actually. This is binary, gender, male and female. This is not binary, so the outputs will vary here. So that's why we need one hot encoding, which will create three columns in your data. Yes, no, and don't know. There will be three columns in your data. Let's say the output was yes. So here I will write one, and rest of the values will become 0. If the contact was no, then it will become 1 and rest of the values will become 0. If again yes, then 1, then 0. Only one value will be, only one of the column will have value 1 at a time. This is the scenario of one hot encoding. So one hot encoding will convert your label encoders into binary by providing you three columns. Are you getting my point, guys, now? What exactly label encoder and one hot encoder is? It's used basically, now you have converted the data into binary form. Now I can use this column. But if the data will be in text part, then I cannot obviously use that column. Because that is in text, obviously text cannot be used. But if you think that after converting into label encoding 0 and 2, there is a problem. Yeah, it could be used for 3, 2, 4, any number of values. But remember, that number of columns will be added in your data. Like if you have 20 categories, like if I go for country column, can you imagine if I apply one hot encoding on country column? Countries are 97. You will have 97 columns with binary. So that's why we do not contain this type of categories. So you have 3, 4, 5, 6 categories, then we can go for that. Okay. So that's why we have three packages here. one first is standardization, second is label encoder, third is one hot encoding. Is it clear to you all? Any doubt in anything? Because these are the first three packages that we generally use in data pre-processing. Label encoder is not working here because the values are 0, 1, 2. So it means 2 has a greater impact, 1 has less, and 0 do not have any impact. Actually, this is what 0, 1, 2 means. So that's why I converted the data into binary. Please repeat contact and don't know value. Okay. What kind of variable feature scaling is done? Why not only one hot encoding? We cannot directly apply one hot encoding because one hot encoding is applied on label encoder's object. So that's why first we have to apply label encoder, then we have to apply one hot encoder. Explain standard scaler. Actually, standard scaler was used so that I can scale my data on a lower range. Like if I have the range, in my data, you can see the range is like, for some column, it is very huge. For some column, it is very low. So the range is different for all the columns. And might be if you're getting some columns like which has values in lakhs or crores. So that's why we need to scale our data so that it will be converted into a small scale. Now, two benefits. First is speed will be faster of your execution because the calculation will be done on small values. So that's why the speed will be better of the calculation. Second benefit, you can easily visualize these type of data sets on graphs when you have these small scale values. So this is the standard scaler why we did it. To what kind of variable feature scaling is done? Basically, when you are applying feature scaling, it will be applied all the columns. It is not specified that I'll be applying feature scaling only on age column or fever column. It will be applied to all the data if you are applying feature scaling. Okay, so feature scaling is applied to all the columns. Whenever you are applying it, it won't be applied only for a single column. One hot encoding is better, or it's better to change the data in Excel and numeric. I think one hot encoding is better because now the control is in your hand. Like in future, if you are getting the data in Excel, it is changing continuously. You cannot change again and again your Excel file, but you can handle the things using your code. If you are continuously getting the values from the Excel file at your coding part, you are continuously using one hot encoding to convert them. So I think you can just change the data in your code, one hot encoding, using one hot encoding. Yeah, we can apply one hot encoding on few columns. If we have 450 unique values in a column, then in this encoding we have to change. It means if you have 450 unique value, then are you going to implement one hot encoding? You are saying that. Actually, if you have 450 unique value, then you can apply one hot encoding. There is no issue with that. But remember what will be the shape of your data then. There will be 450 new columns in your data having binary values. Okay, but impact I haven't thought about. I think you need to explain your question once. If you want, do you want label encoding on them or one hot encoding? Because if you want one hot encoding, then there will be new columns for you. formula of standardization and normalization. Standardization basically is x minus mean of x divided by standard deviation. This is the standardization. And normalization is simple, x minus minimum value of x divided by maximum of x minus minimum of x. It will return you the values between 0 and 1. This is normalization, and second one is standardization. For 5 values, if you have 5 values, then one hot encoding will be like you have yes, no, don't know, and let's say some other column like maybe. And let's say after that we have none, like this. Okay, I just have written this. So all the values will be zero. Nothing will be changed here. When you have assigned something one, the rest of the columns will become zero at that moment. If you have five values, the output will be look like this. Okay. Okay, is it clear to you when you have to apply for 5 columns? X is the column value. X is the column value in the formula, I think you are asking. Yeah, X is the column value. X is the actual value of your data. Yeah, X is the observation.
You can notice that each slide I also
have to mute your mic.
Please, you can raise your hands so that I can answer your question.
Guys, please turn off your mic.
Please don't open your mic during the session. It creates lots of disturbance. Ravi sir, you can please continue.
Okay, sir. Okay, is there any other doubt? Is there a possibility that both cases are true? What both cases? Which both cases you are talking about?
Sir, going as a may or may not be, both are true, given the value.
No, at once you will be having only one value, na? Like there is a column contact. In contact column, either you have yes or no or don't know or maybe or none. Something like that. There is only one value at a time. So only that column will have one and rest of the will have zero. What is the difference to encode the data in single column? And basically when we are talking about single column, then let's say gender. It will be simply encoded into 0 and 1. If I am having only two values. But if you have more than two categories, then you have to convert it into one hot encoding that will contain more than one column. That will contain the number of columns, the values you have in that particular column. Like in contact, if you have five values, five unique values, then it will create five columns for you. But in gender case, there is no need of creating two columns like male and female separately. Can we have one column for multiple values? One column for multiple values means? More than two values. more than two values, like a column can have any number of value basically. Label encoder, the objective of label encoder is simply to convert the data into the number of categories we have into numeric form. Like you have three category, it will give 0, 1, 2. You have two category, it will give 0, 1. This is the only use of label encoder. But if the categories are more than two, then you have to write the one hot encoding. Standardization was basically used so that you can scale your data on a small scale. You can just convert your data into smaller scales. No. For continuous value, you cannot write one hot encoding. It is only for categorical columns. Okay, now let's see the implementation part. That was the theoretical part. By after implementing these things, you will get more clarity. Yeah, generally, it is done with the text columns because we have the values in text. Now, I want to convert it into numeric part. Generally, it is in for the text parts. But if you are standardizing, then first you have converted the text into numeric, and after that you are doing standardization. So first I will apply label encoding, then one hot encoding, and after that I will standardize. Okay, so let's do this thing. First of all, we will apply label encoding one by one. So this is gender label is equals to, make an object of label encoder like this. So I will write down here label encoder and call it. I think we need to execute it again. Might be the session was expired, so let me execute it again. And now let's call it. So first create a label encoder object for gender column. And now I will pass gender underscore label dot fit transform. Now we have a predefined method known as fit transform that will convert your gender data into 0, 1, 2 because gender column has three values, male, female, and transgender. So you will have 0, 1, and 2. So let's pass data set square bracket gender. And if I execute this line, you can see the values are converted into 0, 1, and 2. So let me store these values in a variable. Let's say the variable is gender. Okay, so first I applied label encoding. Now after that, I will apply one hot encoding and then you will see the output. But first, let's apply label encoding for each one. So you have to just write down this line for each and every one. One value in array is 2, yes, because it is label encoding right now, because it is giving 0, 1, and 2. So 0 is for female, 1 is for male, and 2 is for transgender. It is in alphabetical order also, because how you will know that which one is male and which one is female, like 0 is for male or 0 is for female, it will be in alphabetical order. We just mistakenly written here this, so I will write down severity label dot fit transform. Basically, it will assign 0 to first alphabet. Like it is in alphabetical order. Sort the data in alphabetical order. Like female will come first, then second will male, and third will be transgender. According to alphabets. So 0 will be provided to female, 1 will be provided to male, and 2 will be provided to transgender. Okay, is it clear now? Wait a minute, let me tell you. Severity level, I guess it is related to some seriousness, like how much you got something serious thing related, it is simply. It's related to something, your health, okay? Like what is the level of your severity level in health case? Now third one is contact label. So now we have implemented label encoding on each one. So this is the severity. It is again converted to 0, 1, 2. Fit transform is converting your data and applying label encoding on it. So it is a predefined method of sklearn. Similarly, you will get contact variable with 0, 1, 2. Okay, till now we have applied label encoding. Now on each column we have to apply one hot encoding as well. Now after applying one hot encoding, you will see the output will be converted into a two-dimensional array. So first of all, let's take gender 1 hot is equals to this. And it also has the same method, fit transform. So this is the thing with sklearn, that each and every method of pre-processing has same methods, dot fit transform. This is a predefined method here. So the method won't be changing for each and every one. Now you have to pass the gender column in it. And it will convert it into let's name it as gender is equals to this. Okay, so first we created a label encoder object. Similarly, we are creating a one hot encoder object. Now in one hot encoder, I am passing the object that was converted using label encoder. So you converted the gender column here. Now whatever you have inside gender column, you already know it is 0, 1, 2. You have to pass this gender column here. And you will see one error basically after you will execute it. Because one hot encoding says that whatever data you are passing, it should be in a two-dimensional array. You are passing one-dimensional. So you will convert this data into two-dimensional using reshape. You remember yesterday I told you that there is a reshape method which can convert your data from 1D to 2D. Remember everyone? So I will just write length of gender, 1. This is the new shape of our data. And let's see the output of gender now. You will see 3 columns, but by default it gives a sparse matrix. So do you know what a sparse matrix is? Anyone tell me please, what is sparse matrix? Write down a basic short 3 to 4 words about it. Matrix having most of the value 0, exactly. So that's what you have now in gender column. So you can convert gender dot to array. So sparse matrix will be printed like this. So 0, 1, 0. Now you can see this is the one hot encoding applied on label encoder object. Is it clear to you guys what exactly happened here now? It was returning some sparse matrix. I just used two array method to convert my sparse matrix into array. And you have to do the same thing with the rest of the column. Now create a one hot encoder object. Length of gender, one is single column. Length of gender is number of rows and one is single column. Basically, I have to convert the data into 2D. So two-dimensional shape will be, let's say I have data of 80 rows. So it will be 80 by 1. So it is now two-dimensional for me. Sparse matrix is basically which contains a lot of values, zeros. Like you can see all the values are zero. At each row, you will see most values are zero. Only one or two values just became one. So sparse matrix is something like which contains a lot of zeros and few of the values are one there. So by default, one hot encoding object returns me a sparse matrix, and then using a two array method, I convert it into array. Starting from 0 to 1 to column in shape, second argument is 1 by. Okay, let me tell you. Wait a minute. Okay, let me just complete the one hot encoding part, then I will get back to your doubts. Okay. So let me just complete it. Then I will explain each and everything one by one again. Then again it will show you error, because there you also need to convert it into two-dimensional array. So same line I will write. V shape, length of severity, comma 1. And you can do one thing, there is a shortcut that you can just write down two array at the end. So the data will be converted to array directly. And after this, the last column is context. So length of context, comma, 1 again, and at the end I will write 2 array. So first let me show you the output of context as well. It will be also converted into 3 columns. Now I just completed my label encoding and one hot encoding. Now let's take your doubts. So first let me explain each and everything line by line. So first tell me, you know what is label encoding and one hot encoding? Do you know this thing? First let me first answer this thing. Which is better to encode the data in single column or in multiple column? If you have data in more than two categories, then you have to go for one hot encoding. There is no choice for you then. But if you do not have more than two, like you have only two unique values, then you can just work with label encoding. Okay, so I think label encoding and one hot encoding, you just understood the concept. But now you have to understand what code is doing here. So first we created an object of label encoder, which is a predefined package of sclearn. I applied label encoding on gender column. Now my gender column has three values: male, female, transgender. That's why 0, 1, 2. 0 is for female, 1 is for male, and 2 is for transgender. So I told you that whenever you have the data in categories, then you have to apply one hot encoding so that you will have three columns: one for male, one for female, and one for transgender. And let's say the value is 1, it means the person is male. So my male column will contain 1 and the female and transgender will the column will contain 0. See, female is 0, male is 1, transgender is zero because the first person is male, second person is also male, third person is transgender. Are you getting this thing now? So that's what exactly happened at this level. So similar thing happened with the other columns, but there are few changes that we did. First, what fit transform is doing, it is actually applying the label encoding on the columns, because either you have to write some algorithm, you have to write some code, or I just used a predefined package of sklearn which transform my data into label encoding. Similarly, I did this thing with the severity column and the contact label. Now, when I applied one hot encoding, it asked me to whatever column you are passing, it should be in a two-dimensional shape. Now, how I converted my data into two-dimensional? Let me show you here. Let's say you have a NumPy as NP written here. Okay. I will write down comments for each and everyone. Then I will share. So let's say you have array like this. Now, if I say I want to convert this column into two-dimensional shape. So first of all, the shape of my data is 13. So what will be the possible shape of this data? Two-dimensional shape. Only 13 by 1 or 1 by 13. So I write x dot reshape, or I write np dot reshape x. I want to reshape my x. The number of rows will be length of x, that is 13, and column will be only 1. The output will be look like this now. Now this is a two-dimensional data. Okay. So the similar thing I have written there, that I just mentioned the number of columns, the one, and the number of rows, like the length of my data. If you want 2 into 2, then 13 cannot be converted into a two-dimensional with 2 into 2 shape, because 13 is not divided by anyone. So 13 can only have shape 1 by 13 or 13 by 1. If you have data like 20 shape is that, then you can have 5 by 4, 4 by 5, 20 by 1 or 1 by 20. You cannot convert this data into 3 by 5, na? Is that clear to you all, that what actually happened in label encoding and one hot encoding? Now, any doubt is there, then tell me. Any doubt related to the code or related to the concept? First, we had a single column for gender, for contact, and with severity. I converted each data into one hot encoding. Now I have 9 columns, 3 for contact, 3 for severity level, and 3 for gender. These columns will be appended to my data then. In array, 3 columns are given. Yes, in array, 3 columns are given because we have 3 unique values for contact. Why we are reshaping? We are reshaping because one hot encoder accepts only 2-dimensional data. It do not accept 1-dimensional data. So that's kind of a thing we have to do because it is related to the sklearn. Suppose the data in 5 columns, how to reshape? The data in 5 column means like you have 5 columns, or you want to reshape it into 5 columns. So do you want 5 columns in your data? Okay, 4-dimensional matrix you want. Yeah, you can have 4-dimensional matrix, but remember, like I told you that we cannot convert directly this one. But if I try to convert this, if I write comma 1, comma 1. Now this is the 4-dimensional for you. It can be converted like this. You can pass the number of like dimension what you want. How in array three columns are given? Actually, three columns are given because that particular column contains three values. Like gender column is there. Gender column contains three values: male, female, transgender. That's why three columns. Similarly, severity column also contains three values: mild, moderate, and severe. That's why three values. Contact also contain three values: yes, no, don't know. That's why again three values. So whatever the value is present for that person, that will be one, and rest of the value will become zero. Now I think it's clear for all of you that what exactly happened with label encoding and one word encoding. How to find transformation is this only male? I told you it is alphabetical order. Okay, it is in alphabetical order only. So female starts with F. F comes first, so that's why zero. Then male, M. Then one. Then T for transgender. So that's why it is in alphabetical order. So let's move forward now. We want, if any column possesses these symbols, how can we use data cleaning? Basically, then first you have to remove these values. After that, you have to write logic for it. If your data containing these type of star, hash, and all, you have to write down some logic according to you. Yeah, from one dimensional, we can convert it into 2D, 3D, 4D, whatever dimension you want. Because NumPy is n-dimensional array, you can convert any dimensional array using NumPy, like I did here. Okay. But now in this case, it was converted into a two-dimensional array. Okay. I think now we should move forward, guys. Okay. So there was a lot of discussion about label encoding and not encoding. So I think we should move forward. Okay. Now what we will do is, we can convert from 2D to 3D, 3D to 4D. Yeah, we can do that. Okay, guys, let's move forward. Now, I will drop these columns from my data. I will drop gender column. I will drop contact with other person column. And I will drop severity column from my original data because I have converted these columns into one hot encoders. Okay, and to drop that, just pass the name of column. Like I want to drop this column gender and provide x is equals to 1. 1 means column wise. I want to drop this column. So this is my updated data set. So what it will do is, it will drop the gender column from it. Okay. Now I will drop from updated data set. This column axis will be 1. Again, it will be updated. Then drop. Contact with. Let's see the name of the column. It is contact with COVID patient. Okay. So why I dropped these column? Because these was the text. I converted these columns into one hot encoding. Now I will write x is equals to, and let me show you the updated data set. Updated data set dot head. Now the columns are removed here. Okay, I have dropped the columns from my data. Now for x, x's means like you want zero y, row wise or column wise. For column wise you have to provide 1, for row wise you have to provide 0, but I want to drop column, so that's why x is 1. Now these are the remaining columns that I will put inside my x, and I will not take the country column. Okay, I will start from age till the last column. So x will be updated data set dot I log square bracket colon comma 1 colon minus 1 dot values y is equals to updated data set and the column name is infected. So what 1 colon minus 1 will do? It will start from age column and 1, 2, 3, 4 till last column. Minus 1 is infected, so it will leave this column and x will contain these columns. Okay, in x, in dependent variable, I have age, fever, body pain, runny nose, difficulty in breathing, nasal congestion and sore throat. These are the variables that are stored in my x by using this syntax. Is it clear to you? Is it clear, everyone? What is x's 1? I told you x's 1 is column. 1 for column, 0 for row. I want to drop column. That's why x is equals to 1. Now I want to append gender, severity and contact in my data set. So NumPy has C underscore, minus 1 is last column. Yes, minus 1 is last column. It will not contain the last column in x. So let me show you x 0, the first row of my x. Okay, this is the first row of my x-axis. Age, fever, body pain and the remaining columns. And inside y, you have infected, whether the person is infected or not. Zero means not infected for this data. That's how your data is now. Now we will store the remaining columns, gender, severity and contact. Yeah, second last is minus 2, exactly. So C underscore will be used, and I will, whenever I will upload this code, I will write down the comments. Okay, don't worry about that. I will also write down the comments on each and every cell. Then I will share it to you. So concat x comma gender comma severity comma contact. Now this will become your new x. Colon, the blank colon is for all rows. I told this syntax yesterday. Yep, I told this syntax yesterday that when you write single colon, it means for all rows. And in the second part, you are fetching the data from columns. The columns will be sliced from 1 to minus 1. Please turn off your mic. Why we are leaving country field? I'll tell you, wait a minute. So there is error here. All the input dimension axis must match exactly the column array. Let me check the error first. X comma gender comma. We have two dimensional data for each one. Let me check the dimension. Might be there's some issue related to dimension. So let's first check contact dot shape 499 by 3. Okay. X maps is also 2499 by 3, I guess. We have severity dot shape is also okay. We have gender dot shape all the columns have proper dimensions, so again x dot shape is 4997. So it should concatenate the data, but we are facing some error. Let's see, try to concat again x comma gender comma severity comma content. Let me check the what exactly the issue is there. It is related to some shape dimension and all. Okay. I think the problem is with gender, because the gender column has not been stored inside array. All the columns was converted, but gender column I think was not converted. Try it again. Okay, it is executed. So the problem was, the error was, gender column was not converted into array. Problem was, gender was still sparse matrix. So I just printed the gender dot to array, but I didn't store the gender. So that's why we was getting the error. Okay. Now C underscore means concatenation column wise. It will concat gender, severity, and contact columns. Now see the shape of X. The shape of X is now it will be 2499 by 16. Now you know why it is 16. Why we have 16 column in X? Do you know this, guys? Yes, because of one odd encoding, because three columns, each column has three unique column with them. Yes, exactly. Yeah. Are we clear till here? Anyone, any doubt? Why are we getting that error? We was getting that error because I didn't convert the gender column into array. Okay. The gender column was having sparse matrix. So that's why it was not able to convert my gender column. It was not able to put the gender column with this data. So that's why we was getting the error. I want confirmation from everyone. Is it clear till here? Sixteen columns can, because we have gender column contains three columns, severity also contains three, contact also contains three. So we have 9 columns with these three, and 7 columns with X. So that's why 7 plus 9. That's how it became 16. The line for correction was this: gender is equals to gender dot to array. Okay, so finally the data is ready. Now the last thing, we have to apply scaling, and the scaling part is very simple. Just make object of standard scalar and write scalar dot fit transform and pass x to it. And now first let me show you before the first row, the data of first row before scaling. This is my first row. Now we will see data after implementing scaling, after implementing standard scalar. Let's see the first row now. So what output you are expecting? What should be the output of it? Tell me guys, what will be the output after applying standard scalar? No idea. Obviously, the formula will be applied. This formula will be applied to each value, not between 0 and 1, because we are not applying normalization. This is standardization, not 0, 1. Okay, it's not necessary that data will be 0 and 1. We are applying standardization, not normalization. So value will be between something like minus 3, plus 3 to something within a small range. Let's see. Now, this is the data. Again, I'm telling the data will not come between 0 and 1 because we are not implementing normalization. This is standardization. Normalization will return between 0 and 1. Now, after that, let's implement train test split. Now I will divide my data into training and testing part. You will use normalization when you do not want any negative values in your data, when you want a simple normal, sort of like I told you the formula, with using of that formula you will just get 0 and 1. But if you want data something in a normal distribution, when a standard normal distribution, okay. And to understand the standard normal distribution, you must be aware of how the bell curve works. Do you know that? In statistics, there is a bell curve concept. So basically, standardization is related to that. Let's pass x and y to it. And pass a test size like 0.25. So it means I am providing 25% of my data to testing and 75% data will be in training. So X train, comma X test, it will give four things to you. Y train, comma Y test. Now you have four variables: X train, X test, Y train, Y test. Let's see the shape of X train. It will be 75% data now. The actual shape was 2499. Okay, so 2499 data has been split into two parts, training and testing. Now 1874 number of rows will be trained and the remaining test dot shape rows will be tested. I will perform testing on 625 number of rows. Is it clear to you? 5-4 parts, basically training and testing. These are two parts. But training will have data of X and Y. Similarly, testing will have data of X and Y. That's why 4. Can I have confirmation from the remaining participants? Like there are a lot of participants and I can see few of the participants are not responding, whether they are getting it or not. please confirm it. Yeah, 16 columns. 16 are columns. X train, what is X? X is training data, data set, actual data set of your observations. We'll talk about R adjust, I think, later, because right now R adjust is not adjusted here. Okay. Yeah, it's sort of a random division. It will shuffle your data as well. Basically, we divided the data into two parts, training and testing. Now, we have 75% data available in training data and 25% data will be tested. Cross-validation is also a technique used to divide data into train and test. I just use a simple train-test split here. 55, okay, this line again, I think I should explain this line again to you. There is a predefined function known as train-test split. There you can pass X and Y. The X is your training data, like the parameters, the features. Y is the label. So it will divide your X and Y based on your test size. So I have provided 0.25. It means 25% of my data will be reserved for testing and the 75% data will be used for training. So X train and Y train is my training data now and X test and Y test is my testing data. Now, if I print Y train, like if you want to print Y train or Y train dot shape, it will give you 1874 number of rows are available in this Y train because you have 1874 training data. And in the values, the Y will be 0 and 1. The value will not be changing of Y. Values will be 1 and 0 only. No, actually there is no logic. It's kind of a standard. Taking X as capital and Y lower. Kind of a standard. No logic behind it. Generally being in a data science field, you will see a lot of people generally follow this standard. So that you will never be getting confusing about training and testing. But X and Y is it. Is Y column value? Yeah, Y is the exactly your column value, but the dependent one, the target one. Y is dependent column. Y test will 25, exactly. Y test will be 625. Now, shall we move forward, guys? Or is there any doubt remaining? Yes, it divides the data into training and testing part. Yes, we can change test size. You can do it. You can just set it 0.20, 0.50, whatever you want. Why no second argument in Y train? Because Y train has only one dimensional data which is containing 0, 0, 0, 1. Y train will not have two dimensional data. It will not require two dimensional data set because Y train contains only one single column. What is guiding principle for testing and training data? Like if I talk about some, it is kind of an experiment. First of all, in research work, you see there is a lot of things that people work with different strategies. Right now, I just provided 0.25 by myself. You might be asking why I provide 0.25, why not 0 point something else? Because it's kind of an experiment that you run first. After running few experiments, then you understand what exactly you are getting, what exact predictions you are getting from this type of data set. Then you understand what principle this data is following actually. So basically, a lot of things are experimental here. Okay, so now we'll move forward. Now it's time to apply machine learning here. No, same values are not trained and tested. Training data is different, testing data is different. Okay, now finally, we are ready to implement machine learning. So first let me implement, then I will explain a basic about logistic regression. So are you guys aware of logistic regression? Okay. A lot of people do not know about logistic regression. I will explain it to you, but let me just write down the code here. So now we have logistic is equals to logistic regression. I created the object of it. Logistic dot fit x train comma y train. And I will execute this. Okay. Now in these two lines, machine learning is applied on your data. So basically, what happened is we imported the logistic regression package from sklearn, created an object of it. We used fit method and passed my training data. So now machine learning has been implemented on training data. But what exactly logistic regression is, I will tell you. Someone has just written the definition of it as well. Logistic regression is a statistical model, then it is basic form using a logistic function to model a binary dependent variable on the many more complex extension. It's a good definition, but I think few of the people will not understand because there are a lot of technical terms inside. So let me make it very simple for you. Like what exactly logistic regression is. Okay. So first of all, when we applied linear regression, now you might remember that linear regression in the Y, it is always continuous. Okay. And by continuous, I mean to say that the data will be having infinite number of values. It could be in any range. But if your Y has only two values, infected, not infected. So output will be either 0 or 1. So that's why it is simply a binary classification. Can I say this? Can I name it as binary classification? And I'm really very sorry for my writing. I know it's not very clear. Okay, so after that we have 0, 1 and it is known as binary classification. Now logistic regression, the concept of logistic regression is there. It has given a formula y is equals to 1 upon 1 plus e raised to the power minus x. Okay, so the formula for logistic regression is y is equals to 1 upon 1 plus e raised to the power minus x, which results in something like this. On the y-axis, you have 0 or 1. On x-axis, you have observations. So the either data will be plotted on here or data will be plotted to here. On 0 or 1, are you getting a point here? The data only contains two values, 0 or 1. So after applying this formula, after applying logistic regression, it will only give you the answers between 0 and 1. After applying this formula, you will get answers between 0 and 1. So I will take a threshold that is 0.5. And now if you will try to draw a straight line like this, will it work for you? If I say this is my best fit line, am I right here? I don't think so, because this is not the best fit line. So that's why here we cannot apply a linear relation. Here we need something non-linear relation, something like this. And there will be a threshold line on 0.5. So always you will get an answer between 0 and 1. You have a threshold 0.5. You will round off. Either you will get 0 or you will get a 1. This is simply a binary classification. Is it clear to you what exactly happened? What I just told you about it. So we have this equation y is equals to 1 upon 1 raised to the power minus x. We have this graph. The data will be plotted in somewhere between this. After applying the formula, you will have the output something plotted in between 0 and 1. So you just have to do one thing, round off. Either you will get 0 or you will get the 1. It will become a binary classification for you. So this is simple logistic regression, because we cannot implement a linear classification here. Linear line cannot be drawn here. So that's why it is a S-shaped curve. Generally, we say this as S-shaped curve. Now, if you still have any doubt related to this, then just go to Google Images and search for logistic regression. And you will understand that moment I write logistic regression, you will see all the outputs in S shape. Are you getting my point now? I think it is clear to you after watching these images that either the data will be on 0 or it will be on 1. Simple. Okay, so we implemented logistic regression here. And I think according to the code, there should not be any doubt, because code wise, you do not have to do anything. Just import logistic regression package and fit your data, training data inside. After that, after fitting your data, you just have to do prediction. So logistic dot predict and pass your testing data in it and store it inside via predictor. That is my predictions. Now I have applied here prediction part. Okay. Now we have applied testing. We have applied training and testing both the parts. Now let's see the values of via prediction. Let's see what we got at 0th index. It is telling me 1, like whether the person is infected or not. But now I want to check the accuracy. Like, what is the accuracy I am getting here? So there is a function, or let me just print. Do you understand confusion matrix? What is confusion matrix? So let's just print confusion matrix, and you just have to pass y true, y pred. That means y test and y prediction, and the output will be something like this. Now according to this confusion matrix, you will add 296 plus 292. These are the correct predictions. 21 plus 16 is my false prediction. So if you are not aware of confusion matrix, then let's search it here, confusion matrix, and after entry confusion matrix, you will see something output like that. True positive, false negative, true negative. Yep. Used for visualization of performance. And also to calculate precision, recall, specificity, sensitivity, all these type of things. Basically results, the conclusions. Okay. Now finally, we will print our accuracy score after applying logistic regression. And let's see what accuracy we got here. So y test, comma, y prediction. So we got the accuracy of 94%. That's not bad. Okay, is it clear to you now that what exactly happened here? We just applied logistic regression, predicted my testing data, and after doing prediction, I checked the accuracy score. It is 94%. So that's the accuracy in our model. So we got 94% accuracy. It's very good. So now we can test on any other data. Like what we will do is we will take inputs from user and we will tell whether the person is infected or not. So I will take user age. Let's say the age is 23. Gender is male. Okay, I'll explain conclusion metrics again. Wait for a minute. User fever or temperature, whatever the parameter it is, that is let's say 98. User, then we have body pain. Let's set it to 0. It means user do not have body pain. Runny nose was the another column. Let's set it to 0. And what other columns was there? Difficulty in breathing, nasal congestion, sore throat. So age, gender, fever, body pain, runny nose, breathe. Let's set it to 0. Nasal congestion, set it to 0. Thought, again set it to 0. Severity level, let's set it to moderate. And let's say contact with some other person. Right now, set it no. So this is the user data. We just collect this user data from some sort of any website or any mobile app or anything. You can just collect the data from user. After collecting this data, like age, gender, fever, body pain, running nose, breath problem, nasal congestion, throat, severity level, and contact. After getting all these parameters, now remember, you have to do one thing. First, apply transformations, first apply pre-processing on this data, then you can concat this data and apply standard scalar, then you will predict. So what I will do is, I will create a function in Python named as doPrediction and pass data. In return, you will get a prediction. Okay, so let's say I will have gen column, set it to gender. So this is just a short name. So I will write gender dot, gender one what was the column. I will transform gender underscore label dot. So I'm just writing it in a single line. First, I have to apply one hot encoding. But before applying one hot encoding, we have to apply label encoding. So I'm just passing dot transform here and pass user underscore gender. Right now do one thing, do not create the call function. Let's take simply this variable gender. Same thing we will do for contact, for severity level. So basically, I am just transforming my testing data, the inputs you are providing, because the user will give input like this. So you have to perform all the testing part. So I am again converting this testing data into one hot encoding, label encoding and all. But right now I am just using shortcut. In single line, I am converting both the things. So user gender, user severity, and user content. So first, let's see the output. Bad input shape for first one. Gender label dot transform. One more square bracket, I think I need to pass because of 2D problem. Okay, so let's see what is inside gender column. Ideally, you will get a sparse matrix. Yeah. So you have to convert it to array. All the columns will be converted to array. Now I have test data as is equals to, I'm creating an array which is having user age first, then we should have user fever, then you will have user body pain, then we have age, fever, body pain, runny nose, breath difficulty, nasal congestion, one finalist. Okay, so this is the test data. Now I will concat rest of the columns like gender, severity level, and content. So same syntax, C underscore is equals to test data, comma gender, comma severity level, comma content. This will become your new test data. Okay, so test data, gender, severity, and all the dimension must be same. So again, we will check the dimensions first. So it should be in a two-dimensional. I just forgot to mention one more bracket here. Okay, now finally, let me show you the test data. Because the test data must be in a similar shape that you trained on. Now finally, you will get the 16 columns. I guess there were 16 columns. So similar thing I did with my testing data. And similarly, you have to use scalar.transform to perform standardization on this test data as well. So now I have applied transformation on it. Now again, check what is the output of it. The data has been transformed. Now finally, you can apply regression. What was the name? Logistic. Logistic dot predict, and let's predict for test data. So output is zero. It means user do not have coronavirus. User is not infected. And I can also print the probabilities and all. So you can, there is a method known as predict prob. Like that, and pass the test data to it. It will tell you the probability as well of having virus or not. Okay, so like this is the chance of having coronavirus, this is chance of having not coronavirus. So that's why we will go with zero. So So you have to convert it into a proper value, then you will be able to see what exactly the values are. But first, let me tell you what exactly I did. First, I created a testing data, like from the user. Now I will, when I will share this code with you, try this with your data. Input your age, your gender, your temperature and all, each and everything. Your input, your things, input your data. Then just shift enter all the code, because I just applied one hot encoding to this testing data, label encoding, converted into array, transformed into a single data and applied prediction on it. And finally, we got the result that user is not infected. But what if I change few of the parameters, like user has body pain, running nose, and also user was contacted with a some other person. User was in contact with some foreigner. Let's see whether the user is infected or not. So shift enter again, each and everything. So now the prediction is 1. It means user is infected. So you are saying like today 500 infected in corona. What will be infected tomorrow? Yeah, you can also get that. This is basically a time series analysis question that you are asking. Like if today we are getting 500 cases, then what number of cases you will get tomorrow? You can also get that using deep learning recurrent neural network. You can also get that. Okay, so I hope this case study is clear to you. But I think you need to watch the video again, because in the last we just paced up few little things so that we can finish it up. Okay, so I think now we are at the end of the session, of today's session. So we have implemented a full-fledged case study here. Yeah, exactly. Practice is required. And definitely, I think Vishal sir will share the videos with you. Okay, so now we'll have a basic thing so that I can tell you. I will upload few things on GitHub account that will be related to the practice parts. Okay, so first of all, yeah, I will share all the codes. I will share all the codes with you. Okay, do not worry about that. Vishal sir will also provide you videos of these things.
I will share the code and videos, all other things, no problem.
The codes and each and everything will be shared.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Like how Excel file import. Okay, I will do one thing. I will just code the part of Excel file and share it on GitHub. Okay. That how to save these things in Excel file, I'll upload it. I'll write down the code of it in this file and upload it. Yeah, basically, I just told you yesterday that this is the website. You can get all the information. And Vishal sir also shared the URL of our website. From here, you can directly contact us. From here, you can get the contact detail. Basically, we are involved in generally all sort of trainings, like if we talk about AI, if we talk about web development, or any sort of trainings generally related to the technologies, related to the developments, mobile development and all. Okay, so we are also providing summer trainings and all. So, and also there are different batches related to the teachers who's also going on. So teachers who also like we get training for themselves. Okay, sir, I think we will do that particular session. I guess we will just have a basic review from you. like you will just open your camera and then will record your particular reviews, okay? And hopefully I'll be uploading all those reviews on social media as well. So please get ready for that. Yeah, we are also providing training for students, for teachers, for corporate. Actually, we are from corporate background and generally we are involved in right now in each sort of areas. In colleges, we are having our different sessions going on right now. Yeah, students can also be benefited. Yeah, what was your query? I think I missed it. The logistic regression is same NAFOE. What is that? Which we have created for training. The logistic regression is the same. I didn't get after that what you have written. NAFOE. What is this? I think you are asking the logistic variable is same for which we have created for training.
Hello, sir, I am asking कि जो logistic आपने ऊपर regression का बनाया है, logistic मतलब जो आपने regression model use किया है, ये वही variable है जो हमने आपकी जो details दिए user के साथ वो कराया.
Yes, yes, yes. The same variable that we have trained with.
हाँ तो वो जो ट्रेनिंग वाला है दैट ट्रेनिंग वेरिएबल विल बी यूज्ड फॉर द मतलब जो भी हमारे पास आएंगे डेटा उसी में हम दोबारा उसको ट्रेन कर देंगे टेस्ट कर देंगे
या विल बी यूजिंग द सेम ऑब्जेक्ट टू टेस्ट द डेटा.
ओके सर. ओके थैंक यू सर.
ओके सो आई थिंक एकता मैम वाज ऑलरेडी मेंशनड इन द चैट विंडो दैट वी आल्सो प्रोवाइड ट्रेनिंग्स टू द स्टूडेंट्स एंड यू कैन गो थ्रू एनी काइंड ऑफ ट्रेनिंग कोर्सेज दैट वी हैव. Let me go through the section of courses that you can understand. Like, we are generally related to the latest technologies, whether it is related to web development, mobile development, AI, machine learning, deep learning, and all. And we only had this session for 2 days. And if we have more sessions, then I can also tell you about machine learning. The question came from one question came like, how we are going to do the prediction path for next coming day? What will be the number of cases on the next day? We can also predict that using deep learning. If you want to implement ROC, AUC, each and everything will be available inside SKLearn. SKLearn contains the packages of each and everything. How to download copy from your link? Which link? Are you asking this data? Are you talking about this code? I will share the URL on GitHub. The code will be shared on GitHub actually. So let me just upload it so you can download it anytime. Okay, so I have uploaded the code on GitHub. Is training data and testing data done on multiple user inputs? Yeah, we can implement it on multiple users, but at a time you are implementing here one by one. But in test data, if you will see the X table, it contains okay, so guys, can we have a little bit of video session, Vishal sir?
Yes, sir, we can have. I request to all, please, on your screen, those who can. I think 2-3 members have problem with the camera. So I think other people can on their screen.
So we have all the courses related, like except other than AI, we have web development and all also.
I think you when you will close the sharing, then after you can see the screen, sir.
Okay, sir. Let me stop sharing.
Ji. Now you can see the screens of all the participants. Many participants are on the screen. Dr. Swami, Dr. Anjali, Dr. Naveen, Dr. Ravindran, Dr. Richa. Many people have on the Dr. Manoj Kumarji. Many people have on their screens. Dr. Ankita. Good evening, sir. How are you?
Hi, naam sahiye.
आपके दिन खराब तो नहीं किए हमने सर एफडीपी में बुला के?
नहीं नहीं, इसमें अपने बाय चॉइस आया हूं, आपको याद होगा आपसे बात
नहीं तो। कुछ कुछ सीखने को मिला आपको?
नहीं, सीखने को लगा तभी मैंने ज्वाइन किया, तो बाकी एक्सपेक्टेशन पॉजिटिव लग रही थी।
नितेश सर, आप कुछ शेयर करना चाहेंगे एक्सपीरियंस? नितेश सर।
यस सर।
वुड यू लाइक टू शेयर सम एक्सपीरियंस व्हाट यू हैव लर्न ड्यूरिंग लास्ट टू डेज विद रवि सर?
यस सर, आई एम ऑडिबल?
यस यस, यू आर ऑडिबल सर।
यस सर, आई हैव लर्न लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स इन मशीन लर्निंग एंड ऑल। Most of the things I don't know actually right now. From right now, from 48 hours I got many dose from the Ravi sir, and thank you sir for this kind mind, because I am a faculty and I know that how 2 hours are for very difficult for us to judge and answer everyone that with practical, with theory and everything. Thank you sir.
Uma madam, Uma madam, would you like to say something?
Hello sir, good afternoon sir.
Good afternoon ma'am.
Thank you for the wonderful sessions. I attended so many FDPs, but this FDPs was very good, very useful, and for the teaching also you can adopt the many things from this FDPs. If it is good, it will be conducted for the students also, for the final year
yes.
students.
Yes, yes, you can connect to your final year students with the Brain Mentor team, and they will give wonderful training to the students.
Sure, sir.
And how is Dr. Swami? Dr. Swami, how are you? So, have you learned about the machine learning and the deep learning? Dr. Rohini, Dr. Naveen.
Thank you.
Ritika is also there.
Please,
sir.
Ravi sir?
Yes, sir. Ravi sir? Dr. Ritika has attended your session in the BVCOE when you came. Dr. Ritika is our associate professor in the MCA department in our institute, and she has attended your course in the BVCOE, and she recommended to you for me.
Okay, thanks to her.
Good afternoon. Ravi sir, thank you so much. This is my third FDP with you, and every time I learn something new.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ankita madam, would you like to say something to Ravi sir?
Very knowledgeable. Sir, it was an indeed pleasure learning with you. I'm working with R, but the procedure of machine learning remains the same. And really, I felt very good learning some of the process in between. I was not doing that in my research, but now I will cooperate that thing in my research. Thank you very much, sir.
Ravi sir, Ankita madam has attended 3 FDP at my institute. And she is from Bhatinda, and she came from Bhatinda to Delhi for 2 weeks to attend my FDP.
Okay.
Every year I conduct 2 FDP. One is of 2 weeks and one is 1 week. And she attended 3 programs, including this.
Sir, it is you who
motivates.
Yes, who motivates us?
Yes.
Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Dr. Ravindran, sir, how are you?
I'm from Tamil Nadu, Madurai.
Yes, sir.
It's an excellent session by Ravikant. Very interesting, and I had knowledge on ML and DL very well. Thank you.
Thank you. Dr. Kaveri, madam, would you like to say something?
Actually, I'm belonging to the university.
Other participants can mute their mic. If you would like to say, then unmute your mic. Otherwise, mute your mic. It creates a background noise. Yes, ma'am. Rishabh Anand, sir, how are you? Who will chale gaye? Prabha madam, would you like to say something?
Yes, of course, sir. Good evening, Vishal sir, Ravikant sir. I am very glad to attend this FDP, and it has greatly expanded my understanding of mindfulness and gave me great understanding of ML and DL. And Mr. Ravikant Tyagi is highly knowledgeable, and he has done a commendable job, and he's a great mentor. And
that's
I would be looking forward to attend more of Satkai FDP.
Yes.
Thank you once again.
I will request Ravi sir to please come in other program also in my future of schedule FDP.
You call me, I'll come.
Yes.
That's great. That's great, sir. That's great. Sanjay Deshmukh sir, would you like to say something? Sanjay Deshmukh sir.
Sir, let's take a review from Dr. Kashish. Actually, he's from, I think, Saudi Arabia.
Yeah. Dr. Kashish is a PhD from Jamia Millia. Now she is working with the Saudi Arabia. Okay. And she would like to, I think, say something. Madam, would you like to say something? Kashish Shara, madam.
Hello, everyone. It was very informative, though I had some time to food, so I had to wake up early for this, but it was worth the effort. Am I audible?
Rohini madam, please mute your mic. Yes, Kashish madam.
Thank you so much. It was a very informative session, and it was a very good learning experience. We have a difference in time zone. So I had to wake up very early for this, but I think it was worth the effort. I learned a lot from this session, and I'm looking forward to more sessions with you all. Thank you so much.
So can we wind up the session for today?
Yes, I think we can wind up if they all agree.
Hats off to Ravikant sir for his great patience. Answering each and every question,
patiently. Yes. I was saying this thing. You have sent the bouncer of the questions in the first half, but he has replied very patiently of each and every answer. Yes.
He has answered so nicely and with full patience. That's the great quality of a teacher, having patience and activeness. So active. He was and energetic, very energetic.
And he had described the things practical and the theory very smartly. We cannot say that it is an online training program. It is just offline training program.
Not only smartly, effectively also.
Yes, effectively also, sir. Effective. Yes, yes.
Smartly is basically a professional word.
Your thorough explanation, he was actually reading the queries also, and he was answering that. So,
yes.
Multitasking. Thank you, Bharti.
Okay, thanks, and, Mr. Ravikant and Dr. Vishalian.
Maybe I'll get the tears of joy.
And thank you, Ravi sir, also.
Sir, it's a request. Can you share Ekta
Gupta, madam, with us, who is the backbone of this 2 days workshop, who has provided such a wonderful speaker, wonderful resource person to us. And we all give our special thanks to Ekta ma'am for making a collaboration with the Bharati Vidyapeeth and the Brain Mentor for this training program. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. It's my pleasure to be a part of Bharati Vidyapeeth. And thanks to all the participants for wonderful comments, Google reviews. I really appreciate your reviews. Thanks for being a part of our journey. Thanks to all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
I have shared the details of Brain Mentor team at the chat window. You can take it. Otherwise, you can search on the Google that Brain Mentor Delhi. You will get complete details of their team. You can contact to the Brain Mentor for student training or other collaboration. They can also provide live projects training also. I know because I have recommended them my cousin who is working in the industry. My first experience was that. And I sent to him my cousin to train the different technologies. Now we can wind up the session. And we will meet on tomorrow by 10:45 a.m. We will have another good speaker, Mr. Gaurav Arora from India Mentor and Ms. Besakhi Banerjee, who will speak on the how to fill the gap between technology from academia to industry. Thank you very much to all. Thank you.
Thank you,
Ekta madam. Thank you, Ravi sir.
And we will have more sessions related to machine learning, deep learning and all.
Yes. अभी मैं आपको जल्दी से नहीं छोड़ने वाला. मैं किसी को पकड़ता हूँ तो जल्दी से छोड़ता नहीं.
I'm talking to rest of the teachers, faculties as well. I know you are collaboration now.
वो मैं connect कर दूँगा आपको. इन सबसे अभी connect कर दूँगा सर. ये सब जल्दी आपको call करेंगे. सर 2 दिन का 1 दिन का हमें टीचर बता दो हमारी पीएचडी थीसिस रुकी हुई है हमारा एक पीएचडी का कमेंट आया है उसमें ये कमेंट्स में ये कैसे हम बैठ करेंगे ये दे विल कांटेक्ट यू सर
फॉर देयर रिसर्च ट्रेनिंग फॉर देयर सेल्फ ट्रेनिंग व्हाटएवर दे वुड लाइक टू जस्ट आस्क देन वी आर अवेलेबल टू देम
यस ओके बाय सर
ओके सर ओके थैंक यू एवरीवन
Ravi sir, keep up the good work. All the best.
Wait a minute. Those people who are asking about my email ID, the website, just go through the website and you have a contact number, email ID, not mine, but of Ekta ma'am. You can just contact Ekta ma'am anytime, drop your message in our WhatsApp group. It will be directly
shared with me. And you will get reply within the 20 minutes. I can assure this that you will get the reply from my Ekta ma'am within the 20 minutes. That is the maximum time.
Yes, sure, sir. I will share all the details.
Yes, ma'am. You can share on at the WhatsApp group. That will be better, ma'am.
Sure, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you, everyone.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.